from the soul with it.
So Yahoo Sports' Chris Mannix was on the Dan Patrick Show, and he was asked about LeBron James and the Los Angeles Lakers. Dan Patrick spoke about how Lakers fans was in panic mode when the Los Angeles Lakers went 0-3 at the start of the season, but then the Lakers won a game, then they were kind of relieved, then they lost again, and people were back in panic mode. So he asked Chris Mannix, do he think the Lakers will be under a microscope after every single game this season? And here's what Chris Mannix had to say.
I also had to laugh when you had people say, time to panic with the Lakers when they lost their first three games. And then they won a couple, and then were we still panicking? And then now you lose, and are we panicking again? Is it going to be this way? Is it game to game the entire first half of the season with the Lakers?
I mean, every team LeBron has ever played on has been game to game. Remember when they were 9-8 with Miami in that first year, and you know, everyone's firing Eric Spoelstra at that point. I mean, same thing with Cleveland. I mean, it's just we micromanage LeBron in ways that I don't think we've ever micromanaged any player in the history of sports. All that being said, this is what they are, Dan. They're an inconsistent team that I don't think has the talent level to be a playoff team in the Western Conference. Two fundamental things that I thought coming into the season they'd struggle with, they have. One, they don't defend. They're trying to mask it with pace. They play the third fastest pace in the NBA and, you know, just putting up, you know, huge numbers, but they're giving up well over 100 points in every single game that they played in. And I don't look at that team and see a whole bunch of plus defenders out there. They're going to make them get better as the season progresses. They're also 25th in the league in 3-point shooting. And I don't look around that roster and see a bunch of great 3-point shooters. They're going to emerge as the season progresses. Certainly LeBron's going to get better than 20%, and Kuzma probably better than 28%, but they're not a great 3-point shooting team. And if you don't shoot the three well and don't defend well, I don't know how you're a playoff team in that conference.
So if you guys would like to hear the full audio, the link is in the description box. But man, it's crazy how everything that I've been saying is literally happening, like right in front of our eyes. When I made my season predictions, I said the Lakers will struggle early. I said I think that they will be an 8th seed or anywhere from a 6th to an 8th seed unless a major trade happens. You know, if LeBron can get on the phone, call Adam Silver and let him know that we try to get Anthony Davis, bruh. Please, bruh, call Adam Silver and tell him we need Anthony Davis on the first flight to LAX, okay? So anyway, and you had people like, oh man, well, LeBron, he's here now. We're going to get the second seed. We're going to get the third seed, the fourth seed, fifth seed, blah, blah, blah. Like, just because we got LeBron, I didn't automatically think championship, championship, championship. I didn't let the media manipulate me and, you know, like ESPN be doing. But, you know, I'm going to be straight up, firing Luke Walton will solve anything. I think, in my opinion, even if you have Phil Jackson, Greg Popovich, Steve Kerr, no matter who the coach is, in my opinion, I feel like it's going to automatically go wrong. And the first thing they're going to do is blame the coach. And they're going to be talking trades and everything. We have to figure this thing. When I look at the Lakers, I think the Lakers, in my opinion, this is just my opinion, I think the Lakers are in desperate need of a legit closer in the fourth quarter. Someone who's a stone cold killer in the fourth quarter. Just somebody who would say, get out of my way. I'm going to take over in the fourth quarter. I think the Lakers look amazing for the first three quarters. Then in the fourth quarter, everybody's just, it's just too much passing. People saying, Lance Stephenson, we brought LeBron James over to close, so that's what I expect. I don't expect Lance Stephenson to be able to close these games out. If you have high expectations for Lance Stephenson, I understand he's had the hot hand these past few games. But if you expected for Lance Stephenson to keep closing for us and expect for him to keep making those shots, that's going to run out. And like I said, Lance Stephenson is a good role player, but I don't think Lance Stephenson is going to be sealing these games night in and night out. You know, I've been telling everybody about the shooting, which is why Kyle Kuzma should have been in the starting lineup at the beginning of the season to spread the floor. And you heard Chris Mannix say, we are 25th in three-point shooting. And I can only imagine where we at in defensive ranking. And I've watched every game thus far this season, well, except for the Spurs game, the second Spurs game. Just passing the ball don't make you a great leader, as Kobe said. JaVale McGee and Rondo have all been very impressive. And I feel like with this team, with this Lakers team, what I'm seeing, I feel like players don't know their roles. When JaVale McGee played for the Golden State Warriors, Steve Kerr made it clear what his role was. And you didn't see him shooting threes, getting the ball in the post, trying to create a shot. You didn't see him shooting mid-range shots. What he was doing in Golden State is what he's doing great now, which was focusing on protecting the rim. And I'm not saying that he can't be a great big or anything, but I think that Steve Kerr, everybody on that team knew their role. All right, we need you to block shots. Sean Livingston, Steve Kerr, like, I know you're tall. You're taller than most of the point guards. Go play 10, 15 minutes. You can get the ball in the post. You shoot your fall-away shot or shoot over the defenders. Nick Young, shoot threes. Patrick McCall, I need you to guard this person. Like, everybody on that team knew their role. Same for the Celtics. I feel like the Lakers, a lot of the players are trying to be what they're not. I think JaVale McGee has played very well, but honestly, he is just an energy player. I think that's why he looked so exhausted last night versus the T-Wolves, because I feel like he's playing outside of his role. I'm just saying he's not Will Chamberlain and he's not Shaquille O'Neal, but it seems as though the players are playing outside of their roles right now and they don't know their roles. But I'm not mentioning trades as of yet until we get closer to the trade deadline. But I think, you know, the looks the players were getting last year were a lot better than the looks they are getting now, because there was more flow and movement within the offense last season. Now it looks like it did back when LeBron was in Cleveland, and the players are just standing around, still just watching him drive to the lane or waiting to see if he's going to pass the ball to them. There's no cut into the basket, nothing. In the start of the season, it's like the past three seasons in Cleveland, it's like those are the happy stages. Everyone is having fun, going out to party and going to clubs, et cetera, et cetera. The chemistry start off good. But once that new feeling wears off, it's like the losing starts to begin. And that's when the frustration comes out. We'll see. We have the Dallas Mavericks coming up next. I expect us to get that victory. If not, somebody is getting fired or traded. But, you know, I think we should get that victory and go on a winning streak from there. Luke Walton, by the way, was at the top of the list at the betting odds of coaches to get fired first. And somebody has to be a scapegoat soon if we don't get a victory. As far as defense, I'm not impressed with none of the defense throughout the entire NBA. Like, as of now, I'm very disappointed. The way it's been officiated today is just ridiculous. You could barely breathe on players. You could barely touch players. They could travel now. Can't create no contact. You can't, you know, fight for position. It's terrible. You know, teams almost scoring 140 to 150 points in games. You know, the pace, the offense is like up tempo. It's like, man, it's no defense. And the game just starting to look watered down to me. No competition. It's like, it's pathetic. You can't even enjoy the game without the referees blowing the whistle every 5 minutes. It's a shame. Y'all let me know what y'all think. Y'all was this guy online telling me, oh man, well, LeBron is playing with a bunch of scrubs. And I'm like, bro, like, I don't want to hear nothing about LeBron playing with no scrubs. You look at the stat sheet the night he had help. I don't want to hear that, bro. Like, I don't want to hear that. As a Laker fan, we don't want to hear that LeBron didn't have help. Because last year, everybody played well. You know, in the beginning of the season, everybody was talking about how the Lakers are going to get a first seed, second seed, or third seed. They were going to make it to the Western Conference Finals. Now the narrative and everything's starting to change, and now they're saying that he don't have help again. I don't want to hear that, bro. But do I think that we have the talent? Absolutely. But y'all let me know what y'all think. These games have been close, and they've closed games last year. So we ain't got to worry about them trying to get experience and trying to close games, because they've done it before. And only casual fans will disagree with me. But anyway, y'all get in that comment box. Let me know what y'all think about Chris Mannix and what he had to say. Y'all get in that comment box. Like, share, subscribe. I'm out.